Guys, so we're out here with the new project.
Shit.
Yep, that literally just freaking happened. All right, let me redo that scene. All right. I'm gonna play it off like my leg isn't completely wet from stepping into this not so amazingly clean looking water. Anywho, guys, I'm gonna turn this waste on and step in the water. We're out here today trying out the new project, the Albatross. In its current state, it's pretty much just a remote control dual hold boat like this with FPV transmitting. Hopefully some long range FPV with this Black Mamba V2 it has in it. Today, I don't really have, I'm not as prepared as I was hoping for. I don't have the proper batteries, the charge batteries in the transmitter, so we're not gonna push it too far, because boy, I really don't feel like getting in this green water and swimming out there. We're currently out here at the Tempe Town Lake in Tempe, Arizona. Nice calm water. We'll have some airplanes flying over every now and then. Anywho, I'm gonna bring the camera over here and give you guys a little rundown of what we're doing with this, what my setup is like here.
All right.
Oh, man, I really thought I was, luckily down there, there's a ledge, another ledge for like tide shifts down there, because I thought I was going all the way in the water on my phone, wallet, everything. All right, anywho, guys, this is the Albatross, okay? I'm gonna give you a quick rundown. We're running two EDFs. I haven't measured them. I designed them on CAD and just, threw them together on CAD designing, so I should know, but I don't have the exact millimeters of the EDFs, but I'll get that in the next video, an update on this. Got two rudders as well. I know I could have controlled it with differential thrust between each EDF, but it's all right for now. You know, I already had the setup for the rudders in mind and I decided just to go with it. Yeah, exactly. I just decided to put rudders as well, including with differential thrust. A big reason that I wanted the rudders on here is because I felt like, especially with like wind gusts, because it's gonna ride pretty high out of the water, I thought like a lot of the wind gusts would affect it, pushing it like laterally side to side while it was moving. And I thought some penetration down in the water from a rudder would give it a little more stability, at least while moving forward in the water. Yeah, it'll increase the drag, but I'm not worried about this being a speed demon. Okay, under the lid here, which I'm not even gonna bolt down, I just thought about it, I should have brought the stuff down here, but I haven't. It's a long walk back to the car. So we're not gonna bolt that down, we're just gonna wing it. Another airplane. Check that out, guys. Love airplanes. Let's see if we can see it there. Beauty. All right, anyways, back to the boat.
Back to the Albatross. Get to the Albatross.
All right. Anywho, two brushless motors running the EDFs. They're stationed down inside the hole, pushing out the back. That's why the hole is vented like this with these little pop-off vents, because it that's how they're getting the airflow. It's all coming through the hole here. As well, we have two separate bilge pumps. Their flow rate is 240 liters per hour. Okay, if we're taking on 240 liters an hour in holes this side, we're in trouble. They're both they pump, unfortunately, right now at the same time. But in the future, I do plan on having these guys operating via Arduino Nanos with moisture or water level sensors. Jesus, these airplanes are gonna kill us today. Up on top of here, we have the Black Mamba video transmitter. I've seen it used in a couple other videos. This is my first time actually trying it out. I did try it by my house, but only, you know, in close range. It supposedly has a couple miles of range on it on a flat, unimpeded surface. And I figured that that is what this will provide us. But obviously today we won't be pushing it nearly that far. We're just gonna be doing basically a float test. I've tested each hole, because again, it's all 3D printed. So I tested each hole as I was designing it to make sure to be assured of its water tightness. But basically, they're printed in like 6-foot sections, each piece of the hole, and then combined with either JB Weld or a Marine JB.
Overlap
and services. I have seen zero water penetrate through the hole, but I know that the 3D printing is permeable.
I do plan on running two of these Ovionic 5200 milliamp 4S batteries eventually, but for now I'm also running like a 3200 milliamp battery in there as well.
Check it out. FPV camera on the front, which I'm going to take the lens off of now before I forget. We'll be rocking eventually two of these 5200 milliamp batteries, but for now I'm using this other smaller 4S. This 12 volt system is operating the transmitter, the radio link transmitter, as well as the video transmitter, and then the FPV camera, and then as well as the two servos. The servos could operate independently on different channels, which I do plan on utilizing once I incorporate the differential thrust between the two EDFs. But for now, unnecessary, they're both running on the same channel. Using these little small BL Heli 2-6S ESCs, they're 35 amps. I've had good success with these guys in the past. They don't have a lot of power, but they don't warm up and burn up like a lot of the other what are these damn things called? ESCs. And they're also extremely small. All right, that's a basic rundown. Again, two bilge pumps, they operate together. And then also this FPV head is on a servo, so I can rotate up and down and take a look. Because I do plan on eventually on the lid here, putting like some status lights so that the camera can pan down and check on some status lights like voltage indications, water level indications, and things like that. Sweet. So without further ado, I'm gonna get this guy in the water. All right, here goes nothing. I'm gonna power her on. I'm gonna turn, I know normally you would power on the transmitter first. I'm gonna do that last because I have a low battery. I'm gonna power on the system first, and then power on the transmitter. Everything should be wired in correctly. We're gonna start with our ESCs. One, two. Especially in the testing phase, I like to be left alone. I'm not trying to show off my projects prematurely, you know. So I don't like that part of it, but it's all right. We're gonna deal with it. And it seems like we're already gonna have to deal with some of that with this guy coming here and checking us out. And look, like I said, this is supposed to be cinched down. Not even gonna do it. Power on transmitter. We're gonna do a quick systems check. Wow. ESCs do not seem happy. There we go. One, two. Both ESCs are operating correctly. Rotors seem good and trimmed. Video transmission is clear. Let's see. There we go. So I can adjust that visual level there. Too. Of course, I could upgrade. I believe these motors as well that are in there they're up to 6S as well. So and the ESCs are too. So I can push it up to 6S. I just don't think that my EDFs are really going to be able to handle all of that are in there. Like the three, because they're 3D printed EDFs, and I'm afraid that they might shatter. Oh, this is going beautifully, guys. Couldn't ask for better.
Come down here and check out my FPV.
Oh yeah.
That's sweet, guys.
Oh, let's bring her up for a water level check.
This is full
that gives a very small, if any, current.
Also, I'm gonna check my bilge pump really quickly. They are operating, and there's no water in the tanks, obviously, because they're not cutting no water shooting out. Let's see what we look like down in here. Oh man, we're bone dry. We don't got a drop of water. Oh yeah, get a little clip on here. Rudders seem to be operating good. Transmitter's down there, she is doing her thing. Get our focus a bit better there. How's that look, guys? Besides that crooked antenna right there bothering me.
Okay, video transmission is falling.
Boy, that would suck if this thing died, the battery died right there. All right, full steam ahead, let's get it. I do think one of the EDFs is getting a little better flow out of it. Just the fact that I'm a little right trimmed. Nah, it could also just be the trim setting of the, nothing's perfect in here, of the rudders. Bring her up, bring that zoom up, where zoom is maxed. I mean, look at it, guys, it's doing it.
Water tight. Video is crystal clear. Signal is looking good, but battery level is at half. Oh yeah. We're steaming, guys. All right, let's bring her back around. Hard to the right. I don't know port and starboard. I'm just gonna say hard to starboard because it sounds better. Oh yeah.
This thing is watertight in both sides, not a drop. Not to mention, we got some pretty hefty bilge pumps on both sides. All right, guys. Well, that's gonna conclude it for the first short video here with the new project, the Albatross, guys. That's with all of our projects. We have a lot of future goals with it. All of our projects are about starting somewhere and building them, you know, as big and as complex as we can. I don't see a whole lot more scaling happening with this one, scaling up, although it is possible. More just refinement. I want to put an autopilot system in it so it can run waypoint missions. We have a lot of area to work with here on Tempe Town Lake. Especially if we were like doing a circumnavigation mission or something. Oh yeah, that's miles, and we're not even ready for that yet. So anyways, guys, today's test is all about making sure that all my systems were functioning, my control systems were adequate, my power systems were adequate. As with most things, we could use more power and more control, but it's absolutely controllable. I think in our next mission moving forward, maybe we'll start with like a cross the lake run. That's a decent, you know, eighth of a mile, quarter mile, possibly. Not the greatest. You know what? I'll put a little picture in picture map to show the exact distance here in post production here.